Namaskar, this is Aditya. So in this video, I'm gonna talk about one of the most popular question I've been asked on my channel, which is it a good idea to rent a home or buy a home in Canada, especially by new immigrants who are like new to Canada, been in Canada like 1 year or 2 years or 3 years. If you're that person, then you must watch this video till the end, because at the end, I'll tell you what I would choose if I were you, and also along with the pros and cons of both owning and renting. First, let's start with renting a house. Let's look at the stats first. According to rentals.ca, if you want to rent a house, at one bedroom house, if you're in GTA area, you have to pay at least $2,000 or up. And if you want to rent two bedroom house, it's $2,684 plus. If you want to rent a house in Windsor at one bedroom unit, $850 plus. If it's two bedroom, $1,000 plus. So these are the rents that you're looking at. Now, what are the positive things by renting a house? First of all, if you're renting a house, that means you have to pay rent and maybe utilities like gas, water, and hydro. If the owner says plus. There are some cases where you can even get away with that utilities, where you can find an apartment that has all inclusive rents. That's an awesome thing. So now all you do is like all you need to pay is the rent and plus for your living, you know, food and everything. Other than that, you don't pay anything for the property itself. That's an advantage. And advantage two is now because you're renting a place, that means you don't have to worry about anything. You know, if anything breaks in the house, like roof goes, you know, due to the wind, if the roof blows off, you don't care. Your owner cares about it. Your owner come and has to fix it. They have to pay $10,000 or $20,000, whatever, to that expense. So that's another advantage. Another advantage is, you know, now if you are a super busy professional, you don't want to care about anything. You don't have time for anything. Literally, you're just living there, working your ass off for other things, for building your business or whatever. You know, renting makes sense because, you know, or also you're moving from one place to another place. So you're moving constantly every 3 months or 4 months. So in that case, you don't have time to maintain the house. You don't have time to look after your things. So in that case, also renting makes sense. But the cons, the negative side of renting is now literally the rent that you paid for that particular house or whatever apartment, you're literally taking your money from your pocket and throwing out of the window. That's gone, never came back. Let's look at the owning a house, because the reason I talk about that money part, because owning, when you look at the saving side of it, the money that you can make off by owning a house, is there is a huge potential for you to, you know, kind of create a retirement income by having a house. So first of all, let's start with what are the expenses you need to look after if you're owning a house. So first of all, you have to pay the mortgage, which is based on your purchase price. So again, let's look at the stats based on the Windsor board and also TREB, the real GTA board. Average house price in Windsor is 400,000. Average house price in GTA is 800,000. Again, I'm talking about average houses. If you look at one bedroom house, you know, from previous example for renting, I looked at a one bedroom renting, which is $2,000. If you look at one bedroom apartment, like a condo or anything in Windsor, probably you can get it for 200 to 250,000. In GTA, probably you can get it 400 to 500,000, a nice one bedroom condo. Probably your expenses you have to expect in owning that particular piece of property is you have this mortgage. On an average, probably you're looking around $2,400. Plus you have a property tax for that property. Plus you have to pay your utilities. Plus you have insurance. You have to have a property insurance, which is different from tenant insurance. If you are a tenant, you might be asked to pay insurance, but that is like literally $10 or $20 on top of your vehicle insurance. But whereas property insurance, probably it will be like $100 something, depending on, you know, how old is your property, what kind of things in your property. So that's another expense. And on top of that, the biggest expense could happen is like whenever there is kind of issues in the house. You know, house means literally like something will come up once in a while, always. No matter if someone says that this house is freaking awesome, there won't be any breakage, it's a brand new house. Again, even if it's a brand new house, still you can expect, you know, maybe tap leak or maybe a small pipe break. If you did not turn on the heating in the winter time, your pipes can burst. So always some expenses could happen. It could be even your roof due to wind, even it's a brand new, but because recently there was a heavy wind, because of that a lot of people had shingles came off. Again, you know, you can argue that you have an insurance and insurance can pay you some money. Yes, that's true, but you have some deductibility. But at the end, what I'm trying to say is you have certain things you need to look over, and you have some, always some kind of expenses coming up when you own a house. So that's the downside of it. But the biggest upside of owning a house, it's a literally a retirement. It gives you retirement funds. Like if you want to sell this property in 10 years or 20 years, you create a solid retirement funds. Don't take my word. I'm actually looking at a data on GTA area. The properties in 1994, average prices were below 175,000. And right now the average prices are 800 plus. That means if you own a house 25 years ago, most likely you would have got it for 175,000. Now that same house is valued at 800,000. Look at the difference. That means literally you made 625,000 profit. Like you created that equity in your house. On top of that, you paid down your mortgage. In 25 years, most likely you paid all the mortgage. That means your house, like you purchased 175,000. If you had like 150,000 mortgage at that time, now it's already clear. That means no mortgage. So whatever the value you have right now, if you sell that property today, you will get 800,000 and you don't pay any tax on that if you're living in that house. Because in Canada, the coolest thing is for homeowners, when they sell their property, they don't have any capital gain. That means they don't consider that as a regular income, that, you know, when you make money from your job or from a business, you pay taxes. Whereas from this particular house, because you're living in that house, you don't pay taxes. That means that literally you made 800,000 in that house by just buying it whenever you had a stable job and everything. You lived in it. That's awesome. That's a crazy thing. Whereas in renting, you literally took the money out and threw it out of the window. Nothing came back. But by owning a house, you had an average appreciation over the time, and also you paid your mortgage down. And on top of that, yes, your brain might be thinking about, oh, but you mentioned that you have all these expenses, mortgage, utilities, you know, roof or HVAC or other things. How about those? If you cannot survive with that, then of course you look at your income, how much you're making. Make sure if you're buying, make sure you buy within your limits. You know, don't over leverage and don't have a huge mortgage. But there is also another way you can compensate this, which how I started. I purchased a duplex, lived in one unit, rented out another unit. There is a term for this, house hacking, or have a house upstairs and having a basement suite in your house. So you rent out that, and that rent pay off some of your expenses. And I actually made a detailed video on house hacking. Check out that video for more if you're interested on that part. But here is to summarize the overall topic, what I would suggest renting or owning. Again, yes, I'm a little bit biased on owning, but let me tell you this. If you're a super busy professional, you don't have time to maintain, or you don't have a stable income at this point, you haven't settled down yet, then better rent the place for now. But you have stable and everything, you have some little time that you can allocate to maintain your property, or at least you have your wife you know, someone who can take care of those things, I would strongly recommend buy a house. And just be careful with how much you're spending. You know, make sure you're not too much over leveraging yourself. If you're making 5,000 a month, find a house that need, you know, maybe $2,000 to $3,000 expenses every month, so that you have some contingency fund. And if you have a spouse working, then that's another advantage. So now you literally, one of your income is good enough to survive, live in that house. So that's my recommendation. If you are stable, go buy a house and make sure maintain it well, so that you can rip off the benefit over the period after 10 years or 20 years. It could be literally a retirement fund, or maybe a fund for your kids' future. You know, that's what I would suggest. So with that, again, if you think which is better, and if my mindset is correct or wrong, let me know in the comments below. If you like this content, give me a fees, which is hitting that thumbs up button, because if you don't hit that thumbs up button, that means you're taking the free advice but not doing me a justice. So I hope you're gonna do me a justice, and looking forward to check out on the other video. Have a wonderful day.